yes, Lord. Ah, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, yes, Lord, Jesus. Jesus, hallelujah. Ah, yes, Lord, we thank you. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus. You have any prayer requests? Hallelujah. Let it be known now by the raising of your hand. Thank you, Jesus, for the morning. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, Sister McCullough.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's pray for the service today.
Yes.
Pray for our pastor, first lady, and the family here at Apostolic Church of Jesus. Pray for the leaders of the true church, leaders of the country. Pray for those that are less fortunate than we are. Pray for my entire family. Pray for those that have asked me to pray for them, and I can't recall their name. God knows who they are. So we want to pray for them.
Jesus, be pleased, hallelujah, with us, Lord Jesus. Help us to be trusted. us worthy. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to have clean hearts and clean tongues, my God. Lord Jesus, direct us and guide us in the way that we should go. Lead us in the path of righteousness for thy name's sake. My God, we ask you that, Lord Jesus, let thy word be rooted in our hearts, Lord. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, hallelujah, to increase the knowledge and wisdom and understanding of thy word. My God, help us to make changes, Lord Jesus. Help us not to go back to the old way, but continue in the right way, my God. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to be a light unto others. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to do your will and not our will. Hallelujah. Bless those in this neighborhood. My God, let us be a beacon of light to those that are lost, my God. Help us to be ready when you come, my God. Help us to be that church without spot, blemish, or any such thing. My God, bless the man of God. Be anxious to strengthen him on every hand. Give him favor as he goes and as he comes. Give him good health and strength. My God, bless the first family of this church. Hallelujah on every side, my God. Help us to pray for one another. Help us not to talk about each other. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to love one another. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to uplift one another. Help us to think about each other. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to work your will. My God, help us to be the ambassadors of Christ that you called us to be. Lord Jesus, walking in thy stead and caring for your people. Help us to serve one another, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Help us not to exalt ourselves. My God, but help us, Lord Jesus, to humble ourselves before thy mighty hand. My God, we thank and praise you, Lord. Remember each and every prayer request. My God, those is on the altar, my God. We ask you to remember our young people, those near and far. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together for the Lord. Out. And let's say amen for Evangelist Ware as she leads us in our scripture reading. Let's say amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Psalm 66, responsibly. Psalm 66. And you have to say amen. Make a joyful noise unto God, or ye lay.
Sing for the honor of his name. Make his name glorious.
Say unto God, how terrible art thou in thy works. Through the greatness of thy power shall thine enemies submit themselves unto thee.
All the earth shall worship thee, and shall sing unto thee. They shall sing to thy name, Selah.
Come and see the works of God. He is terrible in his doing toward the children of men.
He turned the sea into dry land. They went through blood on foot. There did he rejoice in him.
He ruleth by his power forever. His eyes behold the nations. Let not the rebellious exalt themselves. Selah.
O bless our God, ye people, and make the voice of his praise to be heard.
Yes, which holdeth our soul in life, and suffereth not our feet to be moved.
For thou, O God, hast proved us. Thou hast tried us, and silver is tried.
Thou broughtest us into the net. Thou layest affliction upon our loins.
Thou hast caused men to ride over our heads. We went through fire and through water, but thou broughtest us out into the lovely place.
I will go into thine house with burnt offerings. I will pay thee my vows.
When my lips have uttered, and my mouth has spoken, when I was in trouble.
I will offer unto thee burnt sacrifices of fattening. With the incense of rams, I will offer bullocks with goats, Selah.
Come and hear, all ye that hear God, and I will declare what he hath done for my soul.
I cried unto him with my mouth, and he was extolled with my tongue.
If I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me.
But verily God has heard me. He has attended to the voice of my prayer. 20 altogether.
Blessed be God, which hath not turned away my prayer, nor his mercy from me.
May the Lord have blessings for the reading of his word. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're going to have about 10 minutes for testimony service. We want you to stand on to your feet. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for this opportunity of being in this house.
Thank you for being God
all right. Thank you. Hallelujah. Can we say hallelujah? Praise the Lord, sis.
Praise the Lord, thank.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord's day.
Jesus real to me. The Lord,
trying to get over and couldn't. It wasn't enough time. And I went up like on a snowbank or something.
Yeah.
And came back down. It was super scary. It was a car behind me and God saved me.
Thank
I was thanking the Lord for him saving me. And all the way here I was thanking him. So I want to thank Jesus once again for saving my life.
Praise y'all, hallelujah. God saved my life.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord, Sebastian.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
District 10 service.
March 14th, 6:30 is the pastor's meeting and choir rehearsal, and 7 p.m. is the worship service. It will be held at Greater Northside Apostolic Faith Church, which is where the missionaries did their first engagement. Yay! Amen. We also heard some other good things. We're going to let the Lord reveal that.
Amen.
New Grace Apostolic Temple 13th Annual Pastor Appreciation, Sunday, March 16th, 11:30 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. Honoring District Elder Avery Dumas III, a shepherd sent to serve. The a.m. speaker will be Elder William Lamar of Bethlehem Temple in Belleville, and the afternoon speaker will be District Elder Tony Thomas of Christ Temple Church in Kalamazoo, Michigan. St. Peter's Holiness Church of Jesus Christ, Emma F. Smith Memorial, is having their annual Sunday School Brunch, Saturday, March 15, 2014, at 10 a.m. The subject is A Challenge to Stand Firm, 1 Thessalonians 3 and 8. The speaker is Sister Lisa Armstrong. She is the president of the NDC Christian Education. Amen. Pastor's Aid Love Fellowship, theme, Greater Faith, sub-theme, Thy Faith Fail Thee Not, March 9th, 2014 at 4 p.m. Guest speaker is Elder Theophilus Bell of New Greater Zion Temple in Detroit. This will be held at Restoration Ministries of the Apostolic Faith, where the pastor is Dr. Jeffrey I. Harris.
Amen.
The Christ the Rock Churchwide Auxiliaries Revival, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me, Philippians 4:13. Women's ministry is Sunday, Christian education Monday, ushers Tuesday, come outreach Wednesday, children and teens ministry Thursday, youth ministry Friday, and men's ministry Saturday, March 9th through the 15th. Each auxiliary has their own day for this revival. The speakers, there will be various speakers, and this will be posted on the backboard. Everyone is invited. This, again, is Christ the Rock Apostolic Church Incorporated in Flint, Michigan, with Pastors District Elder Wilbert Reed, Jr. Agape Apostolic Church 7th Anniversary and Building Dedication Celebration.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Dwelling in the House of the Lord, Friday, March 7th, 2014, at 7 p.m., our pastor will be speaking.
Woo! Amen.
And amen. Sunday, March 9th at 4:30 p.m., Bishop Gary Harper will be speaking. We will be in attendance both nights.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us prepare to be a part of their celebration and dedication services. March 7th and the 9th, 7 p.m. and 4:30 p.m.
Amen.
The address is 11117. Whitaker Road in Milan, Michigan.
Amen.
Retreat 2014.
Woo! Woo!
The Apex, the Apostolic Pentecostal Experience, will convene this upcoming weekend.
Amen.
And we are proud to say that the young people are registered. And we have a room. Friday night speaker will be Pastor Marvin Sapp. He is also a Grammy-nominated and winner singer.
Amen.
Bishop Harris, on Saturday morning at 11:30 a.m., there will be seminars at 2 o'clock on Saturday as well. And Saturday night at 6 p.m. will be Suffragan Bishop Tyson of Ohio. This, again, is hosted by the Northern District Council Pentecostal Young People's Union at the Radisson Hotel in Lansing, Michigan.
Amen.
If you have not registered, you still have time, and you can register on the spot. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We are online. ACJesus.net. You can like us and friend us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, watch us live on Ustream, and subscribe to us on YouTube. I don't know if it was announced last Sunday, but we have a schedule sign outside our door.
Amen.
Presented by the Missionary Department. Amen. The missionaries and the young people are on the move.
Yeah.
Amen.
Go, ACJ. Go.
All right. join the young people as we read the Bible in a year.
Yes! Hallelujah!
Follow along with us. Where are we?
Day 54, Numbers 28, 29, 30.
Amen. All right. All right. Amen. And how many are caught up?
Amen.
Amen. If you have missed a day, please be honest. You owe us a quarter.
Amen.
Your quarters help the young people to register for the retreat. So you can miss all you want to. We don't advise it, but if you do, we thank you. Amen. The weekly schedule is as follows, and you can also check outside if you want.
All right, all right.
Amen. Yeah. Monday night, hour of power.
Amen.
At 7 p.m. Amen. Don't forget to fast midnight to 4. Wednesday night, Bible class.
Woo!
At 7 p.m. Don't forget to fast midnight to 4. Thursday night, choir rehearsal. At 7 p.m. Everybody ought to go too.
Sunday school.
Mamas and the papas and?
Children too.
Everybody ought to go too.
Sunday school.
At what time?
9:45 a.m.
Amen. Amen. And Sunday morning service at 11:30 a.m. And by reason of announcement, the Missionary Council has requested that the Apostolic Church of Jesus combined choir come and sing for the council next month on Wednesday.
Amen.
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 So missionaries, please start coming to rehearsal on Thursday. The pastor wants us to get started immediately.
Amen.
So come, your rehearsal will be for an hour, and Voices of Praise rehearsal will be the hour following.
Amen.
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 Hey, y'all excited? We coming up.
All right.
Amen. Amen. Also, there is ministers meeting this afternoon at 4:30 p.m.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. These have been your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly.
Amen.
Now we have the Apostolic Church of Jesus Voices of Praise coming in unto us. Two selections. Let's receive them with a hearty amen.
Amen. Amen.
Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Overcometh shall inherit.
Nevertheless, We thank God for your being here.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
The gentleman that was here last Sunday said that he learned something out of
it. Yes, he did.
We see that he hasn't returned, but nevertheless, God is still God.
All right, now.
I'm sure that whatever he heard is working on his mind.
Come on now, say it, sir.
And we pray that God will certainly work it out, that he shall return to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
I tried to call the young lady that is here, her and her family, that was expecting the child, but that number wasn't receiving calls. So we don't know exactly what's going on there, but we thank God. We thank God. We want to pray for them. We want you to remember Deacon Whitby.
Amen.
In his absence. He doesn't want to walk in this snow and ice, and I can't blame him. Just going out to my car, I was glad my car was nearby that I could grab hold of. Because my feet started to go another way.
All right.
And I didn't want it to go.
Thank you, Jesus.
But thank God that we were able to lean upon the automobile and get ourselves aright before we hit the ground. And we thank God for that.
Thank you, Jesus.
It says, please fill out the envelopes when you use the PayPal account. There is now a PayPal box in your envelope.
Yes. Yeah.
And don't forget to add the 3% PayPal fee.
Amen.
How much?
Amen.
3%.
Oh, Lord.
3%.
Oh,
okay. That's how come I don't necessarily like to use PayPal.
Right, but
just when I go to the gas station, I don't use my credit card.
Amen.
I pay cash.
Amen. It's something that you don't have to. Something that's the same.
When I go to, they got two prices.
Yeah, right. I don't know.
And I use cash.
Yeah.
For those.
Yeah.
Because that's 10 cents a gallon
more.
And I understand because it's 2% on each card that the service station or any merchant uses that they have to pay for that card, even though you're paying for it.
Exactly.
So they're collecting on both ends.
Yes,
collecting
sir.
From you, right. And they're collecting from the merchant.
That's
and
right.
So I'm sorry that we at the church have to add that 3% onto the tithing and offering. Because, in other words, if we don't, that's going out of the church.
Right.
Amen. And 3% can add up real quick. All you have to do is say 3% on a dollar. And each dollar that you spend, that's how much. That's 3 cents on each dollar that they take. You think that's not much, right? That's not much. Start paying 3%. I had some employees. They was going over on the gas pump. And I had to tell them, I said, you all quit going over on that line, where they had gas pumpers. Because they would squeeze and go over the line. So I said, you all guys got to quit going over on the gas pump. That's money. So they looked at me and said, oh, Mr. Hope, this. I said, tell you what, I'm going to set a jar up here. And every time you go over, I say, I just want you to drop a penny in. Mm-hmm. Guess how many pennies I got?
Thank you, Jesus.
They start stopping right on the line. Mm-hmm. See what is going on in your pocket.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't much if they're spending it. But when it's coming out of my pocket, that is your own pocket, it's a different story.
All right now.
So you have to understand that. So to use PayPal, it does not come without charge.
Yeah.
Amen.
But you got to remember that That's why they are in the business, is to make money. They're not here just because they like you. But they want to make money also. So we want you to remember, when you do fill out when you do pay by PayPal, please fill out an envelope, because that way they can better track what's going on, because you're going to certainly say, I want to be accounted for everything I put in.
Right.
So just remember that. Amen?
Amen.
As I said, remember, Brother Whitby, also remember Brother Andrew.
Amen.
In his absence, that the Lord will certainly guide him and direct his steps, that the Lord will lead him in the right manner.
Amen.
I talked to him on yesterday for a few minutes, letting him know that we haven't forgotten him, and that don't let difficulty get in his way.
Amen.
Serve the Lord in spite of difficulty.
Amen. That's right.
It's the objective of the enemy to cut you off.
All right.
Again, we're glad to see each and every one. I hope things are well with Sister Thomas. We see that she's absent this morning, but we're just happy to see each one here. The choir has done a beautiful, beautiful job.
Amen.
They're doing a beautiful job, and I'm expecting the same when they go to the council. Last Sunday was a good time when we all went out and we met at Outback.
Amen.
And all had something to eat.
Amen, amen.
Some had so much they took it home.
Yeah, all right now. Watch out.
Amen.
Amen.
I hope y'all saying all right. I hope you weren't using your hand. But I heard that you all had a good time, and of course we heard that some went over there and they got to shouting along the wall and dancing and jumping.
Passing out.
Amen. We were slain.
Others came back filled with the Spirit.
Amen. Woo! Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Can we say amen?
Amen.
The thing is now to live it.
Amen.
The thing is now to live it. You know, a lot of people hesitate coming into the house of the Lord, even though they know that certain things are all right, but because of loved ones or family and friends, they hesitate to do what they know is right. I can remember one I was telling about the Lord, and they belonged to the Church of God in Christ, and I was showing them in the Scripture what the Bible says. It wasn't about what my church, they always talk about your church. And what they mean is our organization or our particular gathering. But it's not about what my church says, it's what the Bible says.
Right. Yes, sir.
So I was telling them about the Bible. And as they saw what I was speaking, the thought run through their mind. And they said, all my friends are in the Church of God in Christ. Mm-hmm. And my family. I said, well, that's a decision you got to make. And they are, last I heard, they were still in the Church of God in Christ. You got to understand, this is not based on friendship.
Mm-hmm.
And so many people base it on friendship, when you got to base what you do on the Word of God. So, saints, no matter what happened, hold on
Amen.
To Jesus.
Amen.
Trust in him, and he certainly will bring us through. I want to go to the book of Corinthians, the 2 Corinthians. Now, we've been talking about building this building, working on this building.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We want to go to 2 Corinthians. We did allude to this particular chapter on last week. There's so many different places to go into the scripture. Because we have this project. Now, this project did not begin on today.
Well.
But as I read and kind of study, this project has been in the mind of God from the beginning.
Right.
He has planned this out before the foundation of the world.
All right.
And that's why it says he has chosen us. So let us look at the 14th verse of the 5th chapter of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, and the 14th verse. For the love of Christ constraineth us, because we thus judge, that if one died for all, then were all dead, and that he died for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto him which died for them and rose again. Wherefore henceforth know we no man after the flesh, yea, though we have known Christ after the flesh, yet now henceforth know we him no more. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. And all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and have given to us the ministry of reconciliation, to wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and have committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your kindness. We thank you for blessing us this day to rise with health and strength in our bodies.
Yes, Lord.
And have given us a mind, O Lord, to be in thy house, and have brought us, and has kept us, and has delivered us. We give your name glory and praise. We want you to look on those that are absent this morning. Sister Thomas, Brother Whitby, Lord, we want you to bless them, and
yes,
others,
Lord,
that are absent from the congregation.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
we're asking you to send the souls in,
hallelujah,
even from the neighborhood, Lord,
you,
that they may hear thy word.
Yes.
Bless now, Lord, that we stand and give thy name praise, glory, and honor. We thank you for this hour in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
I also called Sister Dunn, and hopefully she will arrive here today. We don't know all things that goes for, but saints, no matter what happened, we got to stay with Jesus.
All right.
Now, to our subject today, we're working on the building.
Come on.
We are continuing our journey through the Word of God as we are laborers and workers together with Christ. And last week, God led us to speak to you about the stones that were cut out of the quarry.
All right.
You know, when stones are broken, they're not easily put back together.
All right, all right.
If they are broken, the builder usually just discard them until the one that comes and carries away the refuge and dumps it. And then there is no more use for those bricks anymore, or that trash,
all right,
or all that right. refuge uh-huh. that is left behind. But we found that there was one that came into the quarry on last week, and when he walked into the quarry, he found those broken bricks. Mm-hmm. They were piling up mm-hmm. on the side.
Well,
and he was concerned about the broken brick. It's amazing that he's more concerned than the brick is concerned.
All right, well,
or the stone.
All right,
now you say, well, stone is dead, but you got to understand, we're not talking about dead stone.
Come on, come on.
We're talking about lively stones.
Right.
We're talking about stones that has feeling.
All right.
And understand and knows that they're in trouble. And really don't want to be in the quarry, but have made themselves comfortable mm-hmm. in the quarry.
Mm-hmm.
We were talking today in Sunday school, and they really got on, I think Sunday school was, watch your speech or be careful of your speech. Control your speech. And they got into the birthing process mm-hmm. and about doing certain things and how that in the church sin has entered in.
Mm-hmm.
Now we must understand when we talk about church, God's coming after a church mm-hmm. without spot or without wrinkle.
Mm-hmm.
Now when we say sin has entered the church, it's not entered into that eternal church, because
mm-hmm.
there will be no sin
yes,
there.
Plain,
but
sir.
What they speak of is the earthly gathering together mm-hmm. of God's people yeah. as they're here in the quarry.
Thank you,
right.
Certain things have begun to be comfortable
mm-hmm.
for the saints to do.
Well,
they fall back or they fall into laxity and they go back into their old things. I should have written down my scripture because the Bible says, if ye continue, you see, we've got to continue in the house of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
In other words, you can start, but you can stop also.
Right.
And the continuing is up to you.
Mm-hmm.
The continuing is based upon your trust and belief in God.
Yes, sir.
You have got to understand that this way of living is a choice. It's not something that you are made to do.
Mm-hmm. Come on, come on.
A lot of people, when you make them do something, they will do it. But give them a chance, and they will sit back, and they will do nothing.
Well.
Even though they know the value of doing.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that I learned while I worked, because I didn't, like I said, I never worked in the factory. Guys told me about what went on in the factory, what they did, guy might be in one spot, and he put one bolt in, put a bolt in, put another on, tighten it, put a bolt in, put another on, tighten it, for 8 hours. The same thing all day long. And I felt that was monotonous. Now, understand this. I applied in the factory, but they never called me. And I don't know why they didn't call me. I don't know, maybe I put something on that application that they never called me. But when I went to J.L. Hudson's, I put the application in right quickly. They called me. Somebody might say, well, what is J.L. Hudson's? It is now called Macy's. There's a few in here that remember J.L. Hudson's. Amen. And some of them have silver hair. And some of them have it colored. And some of us don't have as much as we used to have. Lord have mercy, I lost my thoughts. But the church, those in the church have come to a place that once they have come into the house of the Lord and have tasted of the goodness of the Lord, they have been blessed by what God has done in their lives, but they miss the choir. They miss the action that goes on in the, in the choir. They miss their friends in the choir. But you got to understand, there's a change that comes about.
All right.
Since the master has come.
All right.
When we come into the church, not the church
building,
then God has begun to work on us. We did not fit in the church. As I said last week, some of us were fornicators. Some of us were drunkards. Some of us were idolaters. Some were effeminate. There were many different categories in which we found ourselves. And as we came into the house of the Lord, we still existed in the flesh that we had obtained in the choir. We didn't like the choir. We didn't like ourselves. And we wanted a change. And the master came and offered us a change. The master builder said, I can fix you so that you can work in the building.
Right.
You can fit the building. You thought all was lost when the builders, that is the other ones that was helping the master builder, when they tossed you aside, that is your friend. They said, you can't make it there. They told some, in a few weeks, you'll be back. They said, in 6 months, you'll turn around. You're going to miss this. And in truth, they told you the truth.
All right.
You began to miss But you begin to miss being able to speak your mind.
Come on, come on, come on, Pastor.
You know, they used to say, I start to give them a piece of my mind. But it was the last piece they had.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
It was the last piece they had. And they had better hold on to it.
All right now.
The master came along and he saw what was wrong. And he asked, what can I do for you? They said, Lord, if you would only make us whole. He said, if thou believe,
yes, sir,
thou canst be made whole. Now somebody said, it didn't say that. But it did when the blind man came. And he cried out, Jesus, thou son of David. He was in the quarry.
Yes, sir.
His problem was blindness.
Yes, sir.
Which is the problem of most of the people of God. Their eyesight is stunted. It is fuzzy.
Yes, Lord.
It is not very clear.
Yes, Lord.
And they need an eye examination.
All right.
Why do you say that? Because they cannot see themselves in glory.
All right, now.
They can't see how can they be made whole.
Hallelujah.
And what's so bad about it is that when God has come along and he has reached in the quarry and pulled you out of the quarry, you know you weren't fit to be in the building. I told you there isn't going to be a sound when the building is put together. All of the ache, the hits, and the banging, and the knocking is down here in the quarry.
Hallelujah.
It hurts to be saved. Somebody told you that if you get saved, all your troubles are ended. No, 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 no. You're just now beginning to be worked on. You got a lot to get rid of. And you got a lot to put on. And we have to understand that. It's not easy being saved. You got to change partners.
Yes, tell it.
You got to learn a new way of living.
Hallelujah.
You got to understand that you got to let old things pass away.
Hallelujah.
And you got to pick up new things.
Yes, sir.
If you're going to walk with Christ.
Yes.
And all of those that desires to know Christ. Lord, have mercy. I've got to learn to slow down a little
bit.
But see, I have to try to catch my thoughts while God is sending me.
Come on, come on.
I like Sunday school this morning.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sunday school was has been in the last few weeks very interesting. And listening to the teaching of the Sunday school.
Right.
But there's sometimes there are people in Sunday school that talk too much. They don't give the pastor his proper time to speak. You know, whenever the pastor's going to speak, everybody is supposed to be quiet. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anyhow.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
But we got to understand that God has come into the quarry. When I told Sister Ashley the other week that I wanted her to put on our website, in the beginning, Jesus. Because I know that when I put Jesus, somebody's going to say, the scripture says, don't add and don't take away from the scripture. I'm just waiting on somebody to come and tell me that. I know they want to tell me that. But you got to understand that John, 1 John 1 and said, that which is from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, and our hands have handled of the word of life. You know, you can't handle a spirit. But the spirit, great God Almighty, robed himself in flesh.
Yes, sir.
Because he had to put on an apron. Glory, hallelujah. He had to put on an apron. And that's what the flesh was all about. He couldn't get any dirt on the spirit.
Yes, sir.
The spirit can't deal with sin.
Yes, sir.
So he had to protect himself.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
From the filth.
Hallelujah.
That was down in the choir.
Thank you,
He had to put it on his hands.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He had to robe his face.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He had to get dressed.
Hallelujah.
To come down in the quarry.
Come on.
He couldn't come down in the spirit. Because he needed a solution.
Thank you, Jesus.
Which is called blood.
Hallelujah.
Come on,
thank you, Jesus.
When he come down in the quarry.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
That he robed himself.
Hallelujah.
And when he robed himself, they couldn't recognize him.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
He told them that he was coming. He told them that he would come and save them. He said, then the eyes of the blind would be opened.
Yes, sir.
The deaf ear would be unstopped.
Yes, sir.
Because somebody down in the quarry was wobbling.
Hallelujah.
In their sin.
Hallelujah.
He picked them up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He fixed them up.
Yes, sir.
And he told them, continue on your way.
Yes, sir.
Lord have mercy.
Hallelujah.
He used his servant Paul in the third chapter of Colossians. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, I wish I could preach. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
This is what he told them to do. In Colossians, the third chapter, and the fifth verse, reads us the hope. He said, kill, let it lay aside, let it rot.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let your members rot. Let them stink in your nostrils. Mortify, therefore, your members which are upon the earth. Mortify something with them.
Yeah.
Because if you let them take control, they won't lead you right. The Bible said, don't live unto yourself, but we got to live unto Christ.
Glory, hallelujah.
We got to be fixed up, saints.
Yes, sir.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you, Jesus.
I sing like a song.
Thank you.
It's in my mind. About fixed up. And it started all over again. I think it was a gospel song. Can't think.
Bless you.
Picked me up. Something I forgot. But anyway, when he came along and picked us up,
yes, sir.
Gave us opportunity,
yeah,
to start all over again.
Hallelujah.
Lord have mercy. He picked us up. And told us to start on our way by mortifying. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
The members of our body,
yes, sir,
which are upon the earth.
Yeah.
Read.
Fornication.
We got to get rid of fornication.
Mm-hmm. Come on, come on.
People talking about. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Homosexuality.
Yes, sir.
They're trying to figure out what to do with homosexuals. How to receive them. And nobody is asking, how do you deal with a fornicator? Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The same solution,
yes, sir,
that will clean a fornicator.
Hallelujah.
Is the same solution,
yes, Jesus,
that will clean a homosexual.
Yes, sir.
Help us, Jesus.
Thank you.
Mortify your members which are upon the earth. Read.
Fornication.
Uncleanness. Inordinate affections.
Evil concupiscence.
And covetousness. Which is idolatry. In case you didn't catch it. Inordinate affections.
Come on.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Is the effeminate.
All right. Come on, come on.
Their feelings.
All right.
Are inordinate.
That's right.
They said the preachers were talking on YouTube, and they were talking about how to receive homosexuals into the church.
All right.
You got to accept them just like you accept all the rest of the sinners.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
You got to preach to them,
yeah,
just like you preach to all the rest of the sinners.
All right.
Fornicators,
yeah,
are the ones in lead.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah. Uncleanness. Glory, hallelujah. Some people are so filthy. They just don't understand what cleanness is. If I can give you an example. When I was a young boy, we lived in the ghetto. Or should I say the ghetto?
Talk about it.
Lord have mercy.
Talk about it.
But you got to understand something. I didn't know that it was the ghetto.
All right.
I didn't understand how bad it looked.
Uh-huh.
I didn't understand.
All right now.
Why it was put down.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Yes, yes, Lord.
It didn't look dirty to me. Glory, hallelujah.
Right.
Jesus.
Yeah.
It looked all right to me.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
We had fun.
That's right.
been here for about 12 years.
Well.
And spending 12 years in the ghetto.
Uh-huh.
Mom and daddy decided to get out of the ghetto.
Yes.
Lord have mercy.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we move one step up. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, I still didn't understand that the ghetto was dirty and that it was not a desirable place to be and to raise children.
Well,
but after being one step out of the ghetto and being one step out for a few years, I went back because I missed my friends.
Right.
Help me, Jesus.
Come on.
You know how it is.
Yes, come on.
I miss Johnny.
Bless the Lord.
And little Jack.
All right.
Lord have mercy. And Piggy.
All right.
We missed.
That's right.
I missed them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I had to go back to visit them.
Yes, sir.
And when I went back to visit them.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. That's all right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless the Lord.
They were still in the ghetto.
Uh-huh.
And I had come up. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They thought that I was being uppity. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know how they talk.
Yeah.
And they say you're talking all white.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
I didn't know my speech had changed.
Well.
I didn't know I had changed.
Thank you, Jesus.
I thought we'd go back and pick up where we left off.
Thank you, Jesus.
I didn't know that there was a difference. I know that when I went back, it wasn't as clean as I thought it was.
Well,
yet everything was the same as when I left it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I hope I haven't lost
you. Come on.
I hope you're still with me.
Yes, sir.
Because when you come out of the ghetto,
yeah.
Or when you come out of sin,
yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah. You start on a new walk.
All right.
You begin to walk a new walk.
Come on.
You begin to talk a new tongue.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
But you begin.
Hallelujah.
The enemy begins to talk to you.
All right.
And tell you about your old friends.
Yes.
You miss them.
Freak out. All right.
You know how you used to go out at night.
Come on.
How you used to climb out the window.
Good Lord.
Lord help us. You know how you used to sneak around. You remember the fun. That you used to have.
All right.
Well, Johnny and little Jack are still having fun.
Well,
here you are.
Well,
sitting up in church.
Well,
glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And clapping your hands.
Yes, sir.
You know you're tired.
Come on.
Of going to church.
Well, right.
You want to go back. And see Yvonne.
Well,
and see May. And check up on Rosie. Glory, hallelujah. You want to go back?
Well,
and see what you're missing.
Well,
and the Lord said, don't go back.
Well,
you got a new way of walking.
Yeah.
You got a new way of talking.
Yes, sir.
You got a new view.
Hallelujah.
It's a beautiful view. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
But Satan said, you remember.
Yeah.
And you start to reminisce.
My.
And you start to fall back.
Well.
Into what you used to do.
Yes, sir.
And the Lord has to repeat. feet again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Mortify therefore.
Yes, sir.
Your members.
Hallelujah.
Put your upon the earth.
Yes, sir.
You're in control.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Come on.
And God.
God.
Will take control.
Yes, sir.
If you'll let it.
Hallelujah.
Have the driving.
Come on, preach, Pastor. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
If you let it.
Yes,
Lord. Get in the driver's seat.
Yes, sir.
Preach,
if you sit in the passenger seat. Shut your mouth. Don't be a backseat driver. We're on a journey. We're on a place. We're going to a place.
Hallelujah.
Where there's no more crying.
Yes, sir.
No more dying.
Hallelujah.
No more howling.
Hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Come on, yes, sir.
We got to hold on.
Yes, sir.
It looked like a long journey.
Yes, sir.
While you're going.
Hallelujah.
Up the king's highway.
Yes, sir.
The question is always asked.
Yes, sir.
Are we there yet?
Yes.
I remember one. Lord have mercy.
Thank you, Jesus.
They were so ready to go to heaven that when they went down in the water, in Jesus' name, because we've been talking about this place called heaven.
Yes, sir.
Pastor's always telling us how beautiful it is. Mm-hmm. So he must know something about heaven.
Yes, sir.
He must know where it's at.
Yeah.
So when they came out the water, Lord have mercy.
Yes, sir.
Got drenched. Set by the door. Waiting on the pastor.
Yes, sir.
When the pastor got in his car,
yes.
Ready to go to heaven, go take off. Lord have mercy. In his 2010,
yes, sir.
Buick. He had an extra passenger.
Yeah.
Lord have mercy. Where you going? I'm going with you.
Amen.
Amen. Well, you think I'm going to go? You want it happen? You've been talking about heaven. Forget mom. Forget that.
Yes, sir.
Go on, Ashley.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
Amen.
But we're traveling.
Hallelujah.
Up the king's highway.
Yes, sir.
I wish we could all be like that.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Ready.
Ready
to go to heaven.
Hallelujah.
Leaving everything. I love you, mama. I love you, daddy. But I gotta go. Because I gotta see this place. That the pastor.
Yes, sir.
Been talking about.
Amen.
He can't be talking about it.
Hallelujah.
If you don't know nothing about it.
All right.
He must have been there.
Yes, sir.
It's time for my trip.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord, have mercy.
Hallelujah.
If it only took a 2010 Buick.
Yes, sir.
It might be all right. But we got to put on the whole armor of God.
Yes, sir. Come on, sir. Come on, sir.
We got to prepare ourselves.
Yes, sir. Yes,
I'm walking. Of the King calling.
Thank you.
None.
Hallelujah.
Can walk up there.
Yes, sir.
But
yes, sir.
The pure in heart.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Which are upon the earth. Fornication. Uncleanness. Inordinate.
Affection.
Evil concupiscence. Covetousness. Which is idolatry. You got to understand something. Paul would not have to give these instructions if we really consider ourselves dead indeed.
Yes, sir.
Unto sin.
Mm-hmm.
But Peter says we are living stones. And we are workers together with Christ.
That's right.
So therefore, we have work to do.
All right.
Some of us fall off. But the Master said you don't have to waddle in your sin. Come
on. Yes, sir.
You don't have to stay in your sin.
All right now.
He said, all you got to do is repent.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
After you're baptized in Jesus' name.
Yes.
After you're filled with the power and gift of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
All you got to do is turn to the Master.
Yes, sir.
When you find yourself.
Yes.
Lost along the way. Because you got off the chariot that was carrying you. Say, Master.
Hallelujah.
Call him by his name.
Hallelujah.
His name is Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Call him.
Hallelujah.
He'll answer.
Yes, sir.
He blessed me.
Hallelujah.
For your call.
Yes, sir.
He blessed me.
Yes, sir.
Woo!
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
He will deliver you.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
I wish I had some strength.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Bless me, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
We fell back.
Jesus.
But he's willing to pick us up.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Lord.
And to make us all over again.
Thank you, Jesus.
He says we are new creatures in Christ.
Yes.
Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new.
Yes, Lord.
It's time for us to wait on the Master.
All right.
It's time for us.
Thank you, Jesus.
To hear his call. He keeps calling us.
All right now.
We're almost there.
Yeah.
Don't stop now.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
All right. All right.
Don't look back.
All right. Thank you, Jesus.
Don't be like Lot's wife.
Hallelujah.
And turn to a pillar
of
salt.
Oh, Jesus.
But God is so merciful.
Yes, sir.
He is so kind.
Hallelujah.
That no matter where we are,
yes, Lord.
He's ready to get us.
Yes, Lord.
He's ready to pick you up.
Yes, sir.
Turn you around.
Yes, sir.
Set your feet.
Yes. Hallelujah.
On solid ground.
Hallelujah.
I'm all the way to heaven.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God.
Thank you,
Jesus.
What a mighty God.
Mighty God.
We serve.
Yes, Lord.
I got to stop.
Thank you, Jesus.
Good word. Good word. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless your name.
We need to be in the passenger.
Thank you, Jesus.
They got in the passenger's car, in the pastor's car.
Thank you, Jesus.
We just got to make sure we're in the right car.
Amen.
We got to make sure we're in the right vehicle to deliver us in the right place.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, when you go to the airport, there are different directions that the planes are flying in. Sometimes people get on the wrong plane. But when they get on the wrong plane and they find themselves in the wrong destination, they say, this is not where I want to be. So now they got to turn around and go back. Well, the master's there. He's waiting for you to turn around. He's waiting for you to get it straight. Come unto him. All ye that labor.
Yes, sir.
And are heavy laden. He said, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon thee and learn of me. And I will bless you.
Thank you.
Somebody need to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm so glad that the master is so long-suffering. He is so kind. You know, it's difficult to look into the Bible and to pick out just one thing to preach on. Because when you begin to preach on, there are so many other things that goes along with what God is doing.
All right.
There's so much that God is doing to deliver us.
All right. Thank you, Jesus.
He is so kind.
Yes.
If you love him, don't turn your back on him.
All right, Jesus.
Don't give up on him.
Jesus.
So many folk
Jesus.
Are not as committed to the way of the Lord as they should be.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it's time that we make a commitment or renew our commitment with God. It's time for us to allow God to clean us up.
Yes.
You know, when God begins to clean us up, we begin to wince. We begin to squirm. Because it hurts.
Well.
But if you suffer with him, then you'll be able to reign with him.
Thank
you, Jesus.
He is such a great God.
Oh, yes.
He's such a kind master.
Thank you, Jesus.
You just don't understand his grace. His grace saves us.
Yes, Lord.
His grace provided for us the way of salvation. Don't take God's grace for granted.
All right.
His grace reached out and caught you and brought you in.
Yes, Lord.
He said, hear my voice while it is day, for the night cometh, and you might not hear me. Then it might be too late. I'm so glad God loves us. Not only is he trying to reach the sinner, but he's trying to reach the saints. Too many of us have attachments that we don't want to let go. We hold on to them. And we make excuses.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you.
For what we're holding on to.
Yes, Lord. Don't.
It's not all that bad.
Thank you.
Look at so and so. And they still going to church.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm as good as they are.
Well,
Lord have mercy. I live as good as they live. That brings to mind a young lady that went to church with me down at Bethel Church. I was in the record shop. I had an interest there at the record shop.
Yes, sir.
And they came in. And I hadn't seen them for a long time. But I spoke to them. I said, where you been? They said, oh, I've been doing something. I said, time to come on. Serve the Lord. Come back and serve the Lord. She said, I live as good as those that are in church.
Oh, Lord. Have mercy, Jesus.
I said, that still won't get you to heaven.
Right. Thank you, Jesus.
She looked and compared herself.
Jesus.
We were young. I was very, very young. She compared herself to those we went to church with who were sneaking out.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Doing their thing, and she knew what they were doing and saw them dance on Sunday under the Spirit. And she said, I live as good as they do. Don't compare yourself.
Thank you, Jesus.
With yourself.
All right, all right, all right.
But you got to go above yourself.
All right now.
Look to Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Who's the author and finisher of our faith.
Yes, Lord.
God bless you.
Yes, amen.
I believe all of this here has been baptized in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
You have to commit yourself. Commitment. It's not just saying, I will do it. Commitment is doing it.
All right, all right.
A lot of folks say, I will.
All right.
There was the gentleman that had two sons.
Yeah.
He told the one to go work in the garden. And he said, okay. And he left. But he didn't go to the garden. To the other son, he said, go work in the garden. He said, I don't want to work in no garden. He said, I got something else to do.
Thank you, Jesus.
But he repented.
All right now.
And went and worked in the garden.
Uh-huh.
The father had favor.
Thank you, Jesus.
To the one that rejected. But repented and went into the garden.
All right, all right.
The one that said he would and didn't, he had to cut off.
Oh, Jesus.
Don't lose your blessing.
Yes, yes, Jesus.
Don't lose your place in the kingdom.
All right, all right.
What a mighty God we serve.
God
will deliver us.
Yes.
He will bless us, saints. If you're still in the land of the living, you still have opportunity.
Yes. All right. All right.
You've been baptized in Jesus' name. You still got opportunity.
Yes. Yes.
You've been filled with the Spirit. You still got opportunity.
Yes, Lord.
You've fallen by the way. God will pick you up.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
He'll set you in the right place.
Yes, He will.
He will bless you.
Yes, Lord.
And give you everything that you need. He'll act like you didn't do anything at all.
All right.
Because His blood is so efficient.
Yes, Lord.
It gets out the spots that tie can't even reach.
Right. All right.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Lord.
Lord have mercy.
Yes, yes.
Bleach can't get beak spots.
Mm-hmm.
But his blood,
yes, sir,
washes whiter.
Blood of Jesus.
That's no. Put your trust in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Believe in him.
Yes.
Lay aside every weight and the sin that doth so easily beset you. And run this race that is set before you. God will deliver you. He will set you aright. Don't turn him away. Sing it.
Over the past few weeks
thanksgiving. That's something most people don't like to do. You come to church when you ain't got no money. You go other places when you got God's money.
Mm-hmm.
And you spend his money in the wrong place. When God is telling you, if you give him his, he'll give you more. You come to him and ask him for more when you don't even want to do what he's asked you to do.
Right.
He says this, even from the days of your fathers, ye have gone away from mine ordinances, and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, saith the Lord of hosts. But ye said, wherein shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. God said, you robbed him. As I listened to the news, there were three people that died trying to rob homeowners here in the city of Detroit. Three people died. And see, God saw you robbing him, and he could have killed you.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Had the right
Jesus.
To kill you. But he let you go.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Will a man rob God? Yet he have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. You find yourself short of money? You find yourself with not enough money at the end of the month?
Well,
ye are cursed with a curse.
Jesus.
Well, ye have robbed me.
Yes,
even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse.
Mm-hmm.
That there may be meat in mine house, and prove me now herewith, saith
yes,
the Lord of hosts.
Yes,
if I will not open you the windows of heaven, pour you out a blessing,
mm-hmm.
that there shall not be room enough to receive it.
Yes, Lord.
And I will, listen now, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake.
Yes, amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'll stop that one that's been eating up your money. He said, I'll cut it off. And ye shall not, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground.
Thank you, Jesus.
Money will just fall.
Mm-hmm.
And he won't be able to touch it. Neither shall your vines cast their fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts.
Yes, Lord.
He said, you open the windows.
Mm-hmm.
Pour you out a blessing.
Come on.
He'll give you what you've been seeking.
Yes, Lord.
You say, I didn't come to church to get money. Yes, you did.
Mm-hmm.
You came to get everything God's got.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
He's the only one that has promised you. But there's one that has promised you that if you use your money with him,
mm-hmm.
he'll help you have a lot of joy.
Yes,
all right.
But in the end, he's going to take his ladder
mm-hmm.
and let you fall.
Oh, have mercy.
It's time for us to prepare ourselves in giving. We're to be the head and not the tail. We're to give. And he'll give to us.
Mm-hmm.
When we first come into the house of the Lord, we should learn to give.
Amen.
I was looking at, I had my Bible last night, and I laid it open, and a tithing receipt fell out of it. It was Sister Hope's
mm-hmm.
from 1961.
Oh.
She paid a whopping $14.75 and tithing and offering.
All right.
That was a lot of money at 61.
Amen.
In 1961.
Thank you, Jesus.
That was a lot of money. You gotta understand that. But we make so much. We want God to help us make more money. For what reason? So you can put on yourself. Give to God. Serve God. Serve Him so He can bless you. If you don't serve Him, He can't bless you. If you ain't gonna give to Him, He can't multiply for you. I don't care how much you ask. He's not gonna multiply. But if you do His will, He'll multiply. Let us all stand. We trust that you have received the envelope. If not, raise your hand. And the usher will bring you the envelope. I suppose, Sister Ashley, you have the